Currently, I have the best title for you about the benefits of the last two verses of Suratul Al-Baqarah. Okay, please pay attention for your better future on afterlife. Okay, by the way, Surah Al-Baqarah, the second chapter of the Quran, is renowned for its depth and spiritual significance in Islam. The last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah 285 and 286 are particularly revered among Muslims for their profound meanings and the numerous benefits they are believed to bring to those who recite and reflect upon them. So let's delve into the benefits associated with these verses. The first benefits of the last two verses of Al-Baqarah verse is for protection from Shaitan. Okay, why? Because the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah are considered a shield against the influence of Satan. Reciting this verses regularly is believed to provide spiritual protection, helping believers resist the temptations and whispers of the devil. And the second benefits of the last verse of Suratul Al-Baqarah is for seeking forgiveness. Why? Because the verses emphasizes seeking forgiveness from Allah. Reciting them is seen as means to seek pardon for past sins and to continuously turn to Allah for His mercy and forgiveness. And the third benefits of the last verse of Al-Baqarah is for divine mercy and guidance. Why? Because this verse highlights Allah's mercies, kindness, and willingness to forgive believers who recite and internalize these verses are thought to attract Allah's guidance and mercy in their lives. And the fourth benefits of reciting the last two verses of Al-Baqarah is for tranquility and calmness. Okay, calmness in your heart. Recitations of these verses is believed to bring a sense of tranquility and calmness to the heart of the believers, and also for serving as a source of peace, especially during times of stress or difficulty. Okay, guys, the fifth benefits of the last two verses of Al-Baqarah is for acceptance of du'as or supplications. Okay, why? Because it is believed that prayers and supplications made after reciting these verses are more likely to be accepted by Allah. This encourage believers to Allah with their needs and desires. Okay, and the next benefits of the last two verses of Al-Baqarah is for connection with Quran. By reciting the last two verses strengthens the connections between the believer and the Quran. It serves a reminder of the importance of engaging with the holy text and understanding its teachings. And the seven benefits of the last two verses of Al-Baqarah is for gratitude and recognition of Allah's favors. The verses mention the concept of not burdening a soul beyond its capacity, that each soul will be rewarded or punished according to its deeds. Reflecting on these verses encourages believers to be grateful for Allah's blessings and be mindful of their actions. And the eight benefits of the last two verses of Al-Baqarah is for community bonds. Why? Because by reciting these verses during communal prayers and gatherings fosters a sense of unity among believers, and it creates a shared experience and reinforces the importance of collective worships. And the main benefits of the last two verses of Al-Baqarah is for protection in the afterlife. Okay, why? Because believers who recite these verses with sincerity are believed to be granted protections in the grave and on the day of judgment. It serves a source of the hope and assurance for the believers regarding their ultimate destinations. And the last benefits of the last verse of Al-Baqarah is for spiritual reflections and self-improvement. Okay, and so we can conclude that the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah are cherished by Muslims for multitudes of spiritual benefits. They are believed to bring and the regular meditation and reflection upon this verse serve a means of spiritual nourishment, guidance, and protection for those who seek a deeper connection with Allah. King Muslim around the world help you aware about the benefits of the last two verses of Suratul Al-Baqarah for your worldly and afterlife futures. Okay, thanks for your great attention. Hope you would like to share this content to anyone anywhere, and also subscribing my YouTube channel for growing our Muslim community bigger and bigger. Thanks once more. Have a nice life, as a nice afterlife.